I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
You want to see what the mask sees.
Stay back, don't touch it.
You're curious.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus on
where are we? What is this?
It's the same. It's another world. It's lighter.
It's nicer. I like it here.
The bridge.
It's not broken.
It's fixed.
What happened?
The bridge is fixed.
Let's cross it.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillion, there he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go for him. Before he disappears.
Dillion, don't lose him.
He's slipped away too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillion, there he is.
Quick.
Where is he?
Your curse.
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light.
Do you even remember?
Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The way he stroked your hair. Do you remember the way he felt?
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
He's the reason she's alive at all. He cared in a way that nobody else did.
Believed in you.
There's a way up there. She can do it.
You're nearly there. Shh. Find the way.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
You have no chance. Ever again.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea, and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief and she dies. She's put next to her husband and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
She should have listened to him.
Why didn't she listen to her father?
Years passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
What about wasting your time just delaying minute by minute by minute?
What do you think she's doing?
You're special.
They mean nothing.
Being special.
Waste of time.
Could all be a waste of her time.
What if the gods are just toying?
Playing.
What if the gods are laughing at her?
Messing with her.
It wouldn't be.
She's alive at all. He saw that she was strong.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly blessed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
She knew best. She thought she had light within her when she has only she is pure darkness. What if this is pointless?
What are you doing? Why did you think you could make this work?
You keep seeing runes. You see runes everywhere.
The Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down and turned these bonds to iron and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes. A reminder, perhaps, that if even gods must accept death, then so must we.
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what life feels like?
Look what happens to the few trials.
She destroys.
That are most precious to you.
Dillion!
Dillion never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Sindbad.
You can do it.
I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see. And he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillion's arms, glad to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Be quick. Be careful. Don't look.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you and only you can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
Northmen say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from. The others.
Yes, you can.
The voices, they've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I can't go on. Dillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senor. My father. He taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the soul. You're no coward. He proved that to me in warrior triumphs. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your bet. You don't have to help him.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Don't be afraid.
Dillian, there's something here.
Do you see it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it, one step.
Not following.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
There is more of them. I think they're moving.
You're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
Listen to the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. It will pass. You can do this, anyway.
think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. You are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Tilly. Help me.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.